What's going on, gamers? Today, we are going to go over how to upload a world onto your Java Minecraft server. Before we get started, don't forget to like, subscribe, and click that notification bell to stay up to date on all future videos. Whether you are enjoying exploration, building, or anything in between, a Minecraft world is your canvas. This is brought to the next level with servers, which allow you and other players to work with or against each other in the same world. But what if you started a single-player world and now you decided you want to add some friends to your gameplay? Don't worry, you don't have to start your world over, because you can transfer your world to the server to start right where you left off. It also gives you a chance to use a map created by someone else, but it's a bit tricky, so let's go over how to get started. If your goal is to upload a previously created map from online, we highly recommend only using an official site like Planet Minecraft or CurseForge, since they're more trustworthy compared to alternative platforms. From your chosen site, save the world file to a safe location on your computer, and if it's zipped, we recommend extracting it with a program like 7-Zip. Now find the extracted world folder and rename it to be easily identifiable without any special characters. And once you're done, you can re-zip the world file to prepare it for the upload process. If you're looking to upload a single-player world directly from your own game, then you're going to start with opening your Minecraft launcher and then pressing Installations in the top. Highlight your version profile and then click the Open Folder icon to the far right. And in the new window, you can find and enter the Saves folder. Find the single player world that you want to use, and then rename the folder so it's easily identifiable later on. Then, using a program like 7-Zip, you can zip your world folder, and then keep this window open because we will need it again in just a minute. Since we are uploading big files like an entire world, we recommend using an external FTP program like FileZilla. This is going to make sure transfer speeds are increased while minimizing the chances of a failed upload. Head into your Apex server panel, stop the server, and then use your FTP panel information to connect to an external FTP program. If you have different server profiles, make sure to choose the correct folder and then enter it to find the main directory. Upload the world zip file from earlier until it's finally uploaded, and once that's done, you can return to your Apex panel and enter the FTP file access with your password. Once you're logged in, find that uploaded zip file and select it with the checkbox, and then press unzip in the top right corner and click the green submit button. Once that's done, go back and verify the folder name of the world. After that, return to the main panel page and make sure the server is still offline, and then scroll down to the world section and press the change world button. In the prompt, enter the exact folder for the name of your world, making sure to keep in mind that it is case sensitive. Afterwards, you can restart the server and it'll load up the new world. If you are getting a new world, but it's not the one that you uploaded, first make sure the world folder is uploaded into the main server directory and that the folder itself contains the level DAT file. Additionally, if you do have separate server profiles, make sure you're clicking the correct profile before uploading the world. If the server is crashing or certain buildings are missing, there might be an issue with the upload process or the world itself. Keep in mind that the server should match the version of the world you're attempting to use. If you're using a newer world on an older server version, it could cause a crash. We also recommend only uploading zipped files for your world rather than the entire folder. This is going to transfer all the files at once instead of potentially encountering errors with each individual world file. Whether you want to start a server with a pre-made world, or if you've had your own that you want to have friends join in on, uploading a world to your server is the way to do it. And by following these steps, you'll be back to playing in no time. That's all for this one, and as always, I hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.